I'm Bertrand Piccard, an explorer and clean technology pioneer. I've teamed up with science journalist Sam Pauly, and we're traveling over 1,000 kilometers across Switzerland using only zero fossil fuels vehicles, discovering hydropower's role in building the carbon neutral future upon which we depend.
We've made it to Lausanne and the beautiful Lake Geneva.
So I couldn't resist the opportunity to try out one of the many electric boats available for hire on the lake. It's not as easy as it looks. In this episode, we'll be finding out about using existing resources in innovative ways and taking a closer look at sustainable hydropower.
For hydropower to make real progress, collaboration is key. Environmentally, economically, and politically.
Throughout our journey, we're hearing from some global thought leaders on the energy transition. Climate activist and former First Lady of Costa Rica, Claudia Dobles, who was key in the country's shift to renewable energy. Ignacio Cassis, president of the Swiss Confederation. And former head of the UN Environment Programme, Eric Solheim, a global leader on environment and development.
How important then are existing technologies? Do we have everything that we really need to meet this challenge?
There will be enormous technological progress in the years to come, but still at this point in 2022, we still have all the technologies we need, and we just need to implement it at a larger scale.
There are many obstacles. One of maybe the first one is the mindset of the people. We have to be convinced to take our times and so on.
There is this myth that if you go green, you go more expensive, and that's not true.
Hydropower is one of the oldest and largest sources of renewable energy. It's reliable and flexible as it uses a natural flow of moving water to generate electricity.
Today, dams are being built in a sustainable and responsible manner. And with nearly 10,000 hydropower dams around the world, there's a golden opportunity to regenerate older dams to ensure that they serve many generations to come. I'm here high up in the Swiss Alps at the Elektromesse hydropower station,
which is over half a century old, and it was built to use water from the river Masse,
which lies at the foot of Europe's biggest glacier, the Elech glacier. But the generators have reached the end of their life. This could have meant that the plant would no longer be operational. Instead, two new state-of-the-art generators and transformers will replace the previous equipment and improve the power plant's overall efficiency.
Modernisation here at Bitch is just absolutely essential because the work on the units means that the power station could be working for around another 60 years.
So when you look at that ratio of the energy you put in when you built it, so the carbon you spend building it, compared to the energy that gives back, these plants give us back during their lifetime, because they're 100 years lifetime, that ratio is about 168 to 1. Hydro is part of an overall system that we have to construct as a society.
So Sam, you left me earlier to go to another dam, which was called Bitch.
Bitch was just great. It's over half a century old, and it's been built to be fed by water from a river, the River Masse, which is at the foot of a glacier. But what's really exciting is that they're going to modernize it, and that is going to give this place a new lease of life, which is just fantastic. It's just this perfect illustration of the need that we need to be finding these other solutions, isn't it?
So many solutions already exist, but businesses still need to think creatively and look for new and better ways of working. Being carbon neutral is an important goal, but this can be exceeded by being carbon neutral plus, just like Unterburg Farm here in the north of Switzerland.
Wir sind hier ein typischer Familienbetrieb. Wir haben drei Arten von Energie, einerseits der normale Strom, andererseits die Wärme, wo wir Häuser heizen und mit warmem Wasser beliefern, und als drittes die Biogas-Tankstelle, um Fahrzeuge zu tanken. Selbst unser Traktor läuft mit dem selber produzierten Biogas. Wir sind nicht nur CO2-neutral, sondern wir sind sogar CO2-plus. Also wir verbrauchen auf dem Betrieb weniger, wieder das wir einsparen.
In our final episode, we'll be visiting the Limon Pump Storage Plant, an amazing example of renewables working in harmony together. Sam looks at e-mobility in practice, and we'll hear more on global efforts. Join us then.